them. Okay, so there may be some interesting omissions from this talk, but it's all part of the fun. I decided to write it on the plane on the way here because it was more important that before that I finish the actual talk I'm giving on Thursday. And of course, jumped on the plane and went, okay, cool, let's revise it, and realized, of course, without net access, I really had no idea what was going on. So this mainly contains the lies that I made up on the plane, plus any updates that I got as I was being driven here by Marco, tethering through my phone, trying to search for the bits that I didn't know. So this will be, even for me, an unusually unreliable guide to LCA. Cool. So let's begin. Welcome. I guess this is the first semi-official thing that's happening at LCA, I should say. Welcome to you. Now, there are supposed to be two presenters, and I was supposed to stand under here, and Kelly was supposed to stand over there. Unfortunately, for various reasons, Kelly can't make it until Tuesday, and we didn't figure that out until it was too late for me either to get a replacement or produce a giant life-size cardboard cutout, so just which I absolutely would have done. So I'm actually going to give this by myself, which is untried territory, because in previous years, I've always had a co-presenter to correct my mistakes. Okay, so this is what it's going to look like. Where am I? What's happening? How did we get here? And then advice, secrets, and lies at the end. Okay, so where am I? This is a roving, free and open source software technical conference. It is very, very important to remember that it is a fresh volunteer team every year that does this. Less fresh about this time, but they start off fresh and enthusiastic anyway before the conference proper. That's really important to remember. So these people are not paid. They don't get to attend the conference or do anything fun at all for the month preceding or the month afterwards. The umbrella organisation that puts all this on is Linux Australia, and they usually run the AGM and have stuff that happens in the schedule. I think you'll see that again this year. Okay, the important stuff, what's happening? This is your week. Any questions? Okay, we're going to break this down into small bite-sized pieces, but that is basically what the week is going to look like. Okay, mini conference. The first 2 days of the conference are sort of the warm-up, semi-official, we take no responsibility kind of days. These are independently run sub-conferences, basically. They are provided with a room and some space on the web page, and that's it. Now, every year, the paper conference committee wants to point out that they have nothing to do with the selection of the speakers or presenters at the mini-conference. And as I'm on the paper committee again this year, I particularly want to point out, we have nothing to do with this. So the first 2 days are basically these little conferences that are in related areas, but we have nothing to do with it. So if they suck, don't blame us. The only thing we do is actually the committee do choose which mini-conference to accept each year. But beyond that, it's out of our hands. Keynotes. Somebody said to me, who attended the conference for the first time, I didn't attend the keynotes because everybody knows keynotes are like marketing guff where somebody gets up and tries to sell you something. That's not what LCA keynotes are. The LCA keynotes are the strongest speakers we could find on the most interesting topics. So these morning sessions are actually incredibly important. These are quite probably the highlight. For 30% of you, this will be the highlight of your conference day. So do attend the keynotes in the morning. Do not sleep in. Particularly, 9 a.m. Monday will be the opening in place of a keynote, and they will tell you all the important stuff that everybody needs to know. Cool. Here's a list, a random list of some of the previous keynotes that we've had. And see, I wedged my own name in there somewhere. I like to have a slide where I appear next to these really cool people. So this is it. Take your photos now. Yeah, they particularly wanted me to mention Vint Cerf. Who knows who Vint is? Good, okay. Those people who didn't put up their hands, turn to the person next to you who did put up their hands, and hopefully they won't say, I don't actually know, but I didn't want to put up, you know, I didn't want to look like an idiot. Vint is doing a keynote this year, and I recommend you attend. Tutorials. Okay, so tutorials this year are actually going to be, I think, almost all in N518. These run in parallel with the main conference. Importantly, tutorials take up more than one slot, so you have to give up more than one alternate talk to go to a tutorial. Now, you're supposed to be interactive. There's supposed to be these in-depth how-tos. Huh. But there's a trap. Sometimes the presenter has actually expected you to do stuff beforehand or bring stuff with you or something like that. So you should actually read the description carefully more than 5 minutes before you step in the room, because tutorials often require preparation. So, and I think the Rocket tutorial this year also requires you to sign over your name and all that kind of stuff. And yeah, something in blood, yep. So yes. Now the meat of the conference, the main part, is the talks. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. This year we had over 170 submissions, of which we accepted about 70. That's actually a little bit down on previous years, but usually it's between 1 in 2.5 and 1 in 3 submissions gets accepted. So we've had a lot of options. And it can often be overwhelming when you look at all the streams and all the things that you could be going to figure out what your best options are. And here is my hint. If you can't decide, or none of them look interesting, go to the one that's left most, because that's always the biggest venue. And that is basically the committee's pick on the most popular talk. So assuming that we have some idea of what's going on, go to whatever's in the left-hand column if you don't have a better choice. Cool. Okay, BOFs, Birds of a Feather session. These are not talks. There is, up on the wiki, a list of Birds of a Feather session, and I'll be adding another one shortly after this talk. It's sort of hard to describe what a BOF is. Basically, the idea is that if there's something you're really interested in that is vaguely related to the topics of the conference, then you schedule in a BOF and everyone who's interested just shows up. So it's very sort of ad hoc conferencing, very unconferency. It's basically a widening out of hallway conversations. Often you get into a conversation with someone and you go, actually, I'm sure there's a whole heap of other people who are really interested in this topic. Let's put it up on the wiki. And that's how you organize the beer BOF. So specific topic, very easy. I don't know what the venue is. Apparently there are two rooms reserved for this. They'll be running Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, possibly in the evenings, just a guess. So check out that. Now, there are, who here is a speaker? Okay, any of the speakers not been to an LCA before? Oh, okay, yeah. Tuesday night, for you, Tuesday night, speaker's dinner. For everyone else, Tuesday is you're free to do whatever you want. Your organized evenings are potentially Wednesday and Thursday. Wednesday is the professional delegates networking session. Can I actually borrow someone's badge? Preferably someone who's been here before. Yeah. Cool. Are you a professional? Cool. On the professional, on your badge, will be a little antenna with, you know, mock radio signals coming out of it. That means professional delegates networking session. And that means that you get to go to the PDNS. It's basically the very thin justification for paying a full price ticket if you get to go to the PDNS. The details of that will be on the website, and that's Wednesday night. On Thursday night is the Penguin Dinner. Anyone who has a professional registration or is a speaker or has paid extra to get it, I think, will have a fish on their badge, or a fish with a number sometimes, meaning that they went to the Penguin Dinner. Mark is going to help me. No? Oh. Is that better? Oh, that is much better. Thank you. Okay, so...
I could have just yelled.
Okay. So yes, the fish means you're going to the Penguin Dinner. I recommend it. It's always a heap of fun. Last year, we had a bidding competition on who would be winched up a helicopter. It was very odd. I last year attended with my leg in a knee brace, and there were a number of, shall we say, enthusiasts who thought that I would be an excellent candidate for this. I ended up lobbying really, really hard to get the Wenches for Winching team chosen instead, and succeeded. Okay, on Saturday, there is an open day. I didn't actually check the schedule. Is there anything else on the Saturday, Marco? That's it? That's what I thought. Okay. It's generally open to the public. It's sort of the less hardcore, although exceptions, obviously, cool stuff that we're doing. It's a chance to show off, but it's also really, really fascinating to actually go through and take a look at what people are hacking on. Aha, that got him out of the woodwork.
If you're in the Rockets mini-conf and you're able to be here, then my understanding is the launches will be on the Sunday. So that's the location that we have booked to launch your rockets to 5,000 feet and see if your telemetry works. So if you're in that conference, that's what that day's for. Thanks.
Cool. Okay. So the non-rock people. This is your Saturday. Okay. And that is your week at a glance. But to figure out how this happened, we have to look back at how we got here. And so I'm going to give you a very inaccurate potted history of Linux.conf.au. It all started back, I remember back then, I had hair, and it was 1999 in Melbourne. The horrifically named Conference of Australian Linux Users was run at Melbourne. I think we had, I think I'm going to say 130 attendees. I've got it on there, on my laptop somewhere. It was best standards. But it proved the idea that we could have a Linux free software conference in Australia that people would actually attend. And for reference, I was the one who ran the first conference. So I have been cruising ever since. Because when people asked me, was I going to do a sequel, I said, no way in hell. Fortunately, the guys in Sydney decided to do a sequel. They called it Linux.conf.au. And that was the Linux.conf.au number one. That was January 2001 in Sydney. This slide here, that was my talk. I'm not responsible because I submitted three talks for consideration to the committee, and they not only accepted all three of them, but they scheduled them at the same time across the three streams. So I then had to take my talk and smudge all the topics together to produce a single talk. My actual favorite moment of this was, this is inside of a TiVo. This is where we discovered that Tridge had been doing some TiVo hacking. You can see the PowerPC chip there, if you look really carefully. last time we were in Brisbane, I had a lot of trouble finding really good images of Brisbane, but I just like this image. So, and that was the first year we had a mini-conf. The Debian guys said, hey, we should have this Debian mini-conf thing. And what happened is you turned up 2 days before the conference started, or the day before the conference started, I can't remember, and there was a table with a roll of stickers on it and a pen. That was about the limit of the organisation. You wrote your name on the sticker, you stuck it on, and then you milled around with other Debian people for a whole day. Number three was in Perth, and this is a terrible, terrible photo, but the penguin you can see on your right is actually Linus in a penguin suit. His arrival was leaked, and suddenly tickets sold out. People actually showed up at the conference without tickets and had to be turned away. Linus showed up on stage and then took the head off, and everybody kind of applauded, and it was all good. He returned in 2004 in Adelaide because they got a dunk tank and auctioned off the right to throw the balls to dunk Linus. Indeed, there's the action shot, as appeared on LWN. 2005 was in Canberra. That's Andrew Tridgell, who gave what I would count among the definitely the top five best, most awesome LCA talks ever. Google it if you want. Dunedin, 2006. This is Van Jacobsen. Just who knows who Van Jacobsen is? Okay, a subset of the people who know who Vint Cerf is, fair enough. A bit of a networking god. I have two great stories about this one. One is, I was not on the paper committee this year. And when the list of talks came out, I scoured it and I went, Van Jacobsen. And so I Googled to check it was the Van Jacobsen that they had actually got a paper proposal from. And I went, Jeremy, this is awesome. You didn't tell me the... He's like, who's Van Jacobsen? On the bright side, the paper committee did not reject him. So that was good. The second thing is, and I don't know if this is apocryphal, but the Dunedin guys told me that he just showed up on the first day. And he said, the day before, I think. It would have been the Sunday. And he said, is there anything I can do to help? And someone said, do you know how to crimp a network cable? And he went, yeah, sure. And so they had him actually crimping network cables, the conference setup. 2007, number seven was in Sydney. This, again, is a really, really terrible shot, but this is the open day. It was inside a pavilion. And that was the first year we ran open day. So that tradition started in 2007 and was a huge success. For me, it was really fascinating because all these geeks, when approached about open day, kind of went, oh, well, I have this project. And they pulled out these projects that, you know, you had no idea they were into at all, and they had, you know, had all kinds of weird, wonderful, wacky stuff that people produced that was way away from their normal day jobs. 2008 was back in Melbourne again. This is the stack of 70-odd OLPCs, one laptop per child, laptops, XOs, that got given away to random delegates during the conference. The theory being that people would go away and do all kind of awesome hacking on it. 2009 was in Hobart. That's Linus about to shave Bidale's beard. He auctioned it off. Yeah, he was arm twisted into auctioning it off. And yes, Linus did the shaving. 2010. What are we? 25 minutes ago, I was Googling to find images of 2010, and they actually had a photography competition attached to the conference for no particularly obvious reason. And the Dunedin organizer, Mike Beattie, actually won the competition, which strikes me as a little bit incestuous. But this was the winning shot, and I actually thought it was kind of cool. So that's their image. If anyone has a better one, I'll add it for next year. Okay, so that's how we got here. The conference has roved around a whole heap of places, gathered traditions as it goes. Now, there are some do's. Do attend the full conference, especially the keynotes. Let me emphasize that again. Do attend the keynotes. Try to see some of the talks. That's actually quite useful. And try to listen in some of the talks. Ask questions. As a speaker, I hate it when people don't ask questions. This does not apply to my talk, because it's actually about 10 minutes too long, so there won't be any time. Help out if something isn't right. This is run by volunteers. These are people just like you, just as enthusiastic as you, who don't get to see the conference. These are not professional conference organizers. These are just some schmucks who weren't bright enough to step backwards when they asked for volunteers, right? Since you're obviously brighter than them, if something goes wrong, your first instinct should be to help, right? Just figure it out and sort it. Try to get some rest, particularly those of you who are over, say, 25, like myself. try to sleep at least once during the conference. I like it when people blog or otherwise cast into the internet critiques of talks and events, what they liked, what they didn't like, stuff like that, because I actually look afterwards to try to get some feedback for what worked and what didn't. Because it's often very hard to tell when you're up the front. It's also very hard to tell when you're on the paper committee. Because we get these submissions from people, and they go, we spoke at a previous LCA. First thing we do is Google to find out what people thought of what they said. And it's surprisingly rare that we get really good critiques of talks. In fact, often, you know, people will say talks are great, but they never actually put that into the ether proper. Do not, okay, see nothing while hanging out in IRC. Slash Facebook, slash whatever. Drink much more than you would normally do. Whatever. You normally drink, so you're okay. Drink much more water, but don't overdo it, because those morning keynotes will be a killer otherwise. Don't fanboy speakers. It doesn't happen very often, but when you've got an attendee there who's literally jumping up and down in front of you, it's a little off-putting. Obviously, don't harass others. This is my rule. Do not start or join more than one new project per conference. This is how it happens. You're talking to someone and it's all awesome and it's fantastic. And you're like, I am absolutely going to be involved in this. It's going to be fantastic. We're going to just do awesome things, blah, blah, blah. And that happens every day. And at the end of the conference, you go, I'm not going to get to sleep for the next 3 years because I have committed myself to volunteering on all these projects. So just try to stick to one, okay? And I would recommend perhaps not committing to anything on the Monday or Tuesday. At least leave it to Wednesday to see if it's a really good idea. Finally, your SSH keys have not changed. We do have previous cases of a certain amount of malice involving network infrastructure. So I don't go, that's odd, it changed, I'll just type in my password again. Do not do that. A certain rather prominent BSD hacker got done that way. Okay, secrets. This is really the secret of the conference. There is no magic sauce. This is not television. You don't just get to sit here and watch speakers parade in front of you. The attendees actually are the conference, and the best... The highlights of the conference probably will be something that another attendee told you. One of the cool things about this conference is I know that if, you know, a bus killed all the speakers at one stage, we could pull random people out of the audience and get a conference that was at least 80% as good. Because almost everyone here has something really, really cool to say, something really, really cool that they're doing. It makes it really hard as a person on the paper committee, but we know it's true. And every time I talk to attendees, ask people what they're doing, it's always great stuff. So talking to attendees is really fantastic. And the speakers are attendees. There's no secret speaker cabal room or anything like that at this conference. So the speakers will be milling about. Okay. Yes. There is no cabal. Secrets, okay. The badge, we've already gone through some of them. On the badge that I stole. What else do we have here? So you will have your tag down here. Who hacked their tag this year to say something other than that? Oh yeah, okay, that's actually better than previous years, that's good. You could either hit reload until you got one you liked, or you could deal with all the nastiness and, what was it, SHA1 this year, or was it? Oh, they salted it as well, okay. Yeah. somebody actually asked me and said, do you know what they've done with the thing this year? And I'm like, I think I gave up 2 years ago trying to figure out the iterations. So yeah, if you were clever enough, you could figure out how to modify this phrase into something else. I don't know what else is on this, but if you look at people's badges, you will see different marks. And part of the fun is to figure out exactly what they mean. So, thanks, Nick. Cool. Surprises. There's always a surprise announce. Sometimes it's leaked beforehand. That whole open source openness mentality versus the whole surprise mentality sometimes doesn't gel all that well. But the compromise seems to be that there's a certain amount of leaking that goes on, and 30% of that is true. So there's usually some surprise. The organizers announce that, you know, everyone's going on a free trip to Australia or something like that. there are in jokes. You'll recognize them when you hear them. Everyone else will laugh, and you won't. That either means it's a Brisbane joke, in which case they'll be talking really slowly, or more likely it's some in-joke. Yeah, okay, right. If it's at my expense, it's definitely an in-joke. How will British people recognise it? That's actually, if you're from overseas, then you're in deep trouble. Having had a smattering of the history of the conference, you'll have some idea. The conference t-shirt at Canberra, for example, on the back had a mock IRC discussion where they talked about, you know, hey, I think we've got a conference tomorrow. Oh, who's going to pay for it? Well, I've got Rusty's credit card details. which is a reference to the first conference where I basically put the whole thing on my credit card and hoped that people would pay me when it came due. And it worked. Another reason I'm never going to do it again, because the budget has gone up a lot since then. Next year's conference. So the location of next year's conference is usually announced at this year's conference at the end. So probably at the closing, we'll all find out officially where it's going to be next year. The constant change. Okay, so who here has been to every conference so far? Okay. Oh, yeah. Even if you've been to every conference so far, they keep messing with stuff. This is how traditions are born. The current committee goes, okay, we like what you've done, but we're going to change this, or we're going to throw this out, or we're going to try something else. So anyone who's been here before who tells you, well, they always do this, has a 80% chance of being right, 20% chance of being drastically wrong. So this constant change is something that you actually had a bit of an advantage being a newcomer, because everyone else thinks they know what's going to happen, and you realize that you don't know what's going to happen. So just be aware that it changes from year to year, and so you won't be the only one looking confused. A lot of points. Okay. There's really only one lie involved in the conference, and that is that the conference is listed in the program. As I've strongly alluded to before, the best things at the conference will almost certainly not appear in the pages of the program around your neck. On that note, I welcome you all to the, what are we, 11th or something? 100th Linux.conf.au. And traditionally now, we take all the newcomers to the pub, and we actually have a pub in mind. I believe we have somebody to lead us.
We will.
Excellent. Okay, so we are right now, I'm going to gather my stuff, and in 5 minutes we're going to meet at the top of the stairs, and we are going to march off to the pub, and that way you will know at least one local drinking hole for the rest of the conference. Okay, thank you very much. I'll see you at the pub.